Hey, this is His Word Unveiled. We are in the book of Proverbs today. So we are going to be talking about wisdom and understanding and the power that wisdom holds. So our last video, I thought we were jumping back into Kings and Chronicles and doing that whole thing. But no, surprise to me and so excited. I love Proverbs. They're just simple Proverbs, simple pockets of truth and these messages of wisdom that we can hold to. I love how simple Proverbs is. This is going to be so fun. This journey we've been hitting and really digging in and having to sit and think and study up on things. And Proverbs is such a it's a refreshing book. Just something that we can take one verse holds so much power. One small verse, and you put all these verses together, and there's so much wisdom. So let's do this. So excited to jump in our reading for today. I just read through. So excited to walk this through with you. Proverbs chapters 1 and 2 will be our reading today. So that's what you're going to read. Before you do that, before you hit pause, before we read through, just ourselves and the Lord, I want to read this that's on the side of my Bible. It says, to have knowledge is to have understanding of information about something. To have wisdom is to have the ability to apply knowledge to daily life. So good. So knowledge being the understanding of something, just information about something. Wisdom is taking that information and applying it to our lives. It's actually putting it to practice, not only knowing it, but hearing, knowing, seeing, and then moving forward in obedience and applying it and living it out. And it is that application, that being able to know something and then knowing that thing and doing something with it, applying it to our lives, allowing our situation to be affected and touched and moved by it as we walk in that truth, walk according to that truth. So good. That's a good start, good foundation that we laid, this understanding of knowledge and wisdom. And we're going to hit both of those words and hit them big time in the book of Proverbs. We're reading all the way through, so we're not going to do a little bit of Proverbs and jump to other books. We are hitting the entire book of Proverbs in these next several videos. So yes, I'm excited for this journey. Love that you're joining me. So let's do this together. Now is the time where you sit with the Lord, you meet with God, just you and Him, one-on-one, face-to-face, hand-in-hand, heart-to-heart, sit in His presence, let Him speak, and just chew up these verses, verse by verse. Again, there's so much power. They're so simple, simply put, so let's not rush over. Let's read, let's chew on it for a little bit, let it soak in, let it do something to us, apply wisdom and allowing it to be applied and allowing it to just take over our life, giving us a new perspective, a new way of doing life itself. So yes, it's on Proverbs chapters 1 and 2. You go read, let God speak, let's let God move, let's let Him change us through our reading today. So you go do that, I'm praying, and let's do this thing in Proverbs. Lord, we love You and we thank You for You being our wisdom. Thank You for Your heart being given to us. Thank You for desiring us to be free, to live in wisdom, according to wisdom, so that we can encounter You. We can experience abundant life, real life, a life that leads us into peace, knowing that if we fear You, if we look to You as our wisdom, and we are led by You, by our wisdom, by our instruction, by our leader and our helper and our guide. Father, if we look to You as You lead us, then we will be led into victory. We'll be led into more. We'll be led into growth, more and more of You. Father, thank You for choosing to speak to us, for choosing to lead us, for not sitting back and watching us just wallow in our shame and fail miserably. Lord, You beckon us to come to You. You draw us in. You lead us into and upon paths that lead into peace, into righteousness, into the fullness of life. Lord, thank You for desiring that for us, desiring for us to be led there, to come into such peace, such abundant life. Father, thank You for loving us. Thank You for caring about every detail in our lives. Thank You for seeing us, for hearing us, for speaking to us. Lord, we love You, and we're so excited about the wisdom that we will see, that we will grow in as we walk through the book of Proverbs. Father, just lay out your truth to us and allow it to change us. We want to be moved by your Spirit today as we dive into your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Proverbs chapter 1, let's jump into it. Okay, starts right off the Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel. So Solomon is writing these again when God said, Solomon, what do you want from me? And Solomon says, wisdom. That's what he asked for above any, all riches, all fame, all honor. He wanted wisdom so that he could judge the people righteously, that he could do what was right, so that he could do things that held purpose, that held effective results in the people's lives. He wanted to truly help them. He wanted to do something that was right, that led into something bigger and more than himself. So he asked for wisdom. And in this, he wrote the entire book of Proverbs according to the wisdom that God gave to Solomon. Verse 2, to know wisdom and instruction, to discern the sayings of understandings, to receive instruction in wise behavior, righteousness, justice, and equity, to give prudence to the naive, to the youth, knowledge, and discretion. So this is why Solomon wrote this, for all of this to be, to know wisdom and instruction, to gain insight on these things, to receive instruction in wise behavior, to be wise, to behave in a way according to the word of God, where wisdom leads us into more, wisdom leads us into success, this self-control, which leads us into this trust of the Lord. Being wise, we're not going to live in regrets. Moving and responding in wisdom will keep us from having all these regrets and having all this frustration and discouragement that we're stuck in. Being wise, taking a moment to think, to receive instruction, to hear the voice of the Lord, to heed his voice, to follow his commands, that's wisdom. Being able to be still is wisdom. Being able to hear him speak is wisdom. And then being able to take what we have heard, what he's speaking into us, and walk it out, live it out. That is wisdom. Verse 5 says, a wise man will hear and increase in learning, and a man of understanding will acquire wise counsel, to understand a proverb and a figure, the words of the wise and the riddles. This is what I hear in verse 5. A wise man will hear and increase, will increase in learning. I hear a teachable spirit. I hear one who would read the word of God for the 100th time and read it like it's the first time they've read it. That is to increase in learning. That is a wise man hearing truth and increasing in learning. Not just reading and saying, okay, God, yep, I know this is true. I know what this says. I'm so excited. It's such a fun thing. No, it's I love the word of God and I'm choosing to read like I've never read it before. Like it's my very first time, because God can do that and God can bring about a newness. It's not reading and saying, oh yeah, I know that. I know that. Yeah, that story is really great. No, it's reading and saying, I've read it, but I want to read it differently. I want to read it new. I want something new and different for me to learn in this, knowing and believing that there is always a newness. There is always something to learn. There is always a deeper level. When we are dealing with relationship with the Lord, his word, our prayer life, our times of just being still in the Lord, meeting with him, all of that can go deeper. We can learn more. We should never be in position where we have arrived, where we know what it is to be in relationship with the Lord. We know what intimacy is with the Lord. We know what wisdom is. We understand grace. We get what love is. We have conquered and arrived at this Christian level of being able to forgive, of not being bitter, of saying no to the enemy, of turning away from temptation. When we get there, guys, we become foolish. When we're there and we say, we know it, we've got it, you know, we've been changed, we've learned, we've, you know, God took us on this and we're good to go and it's changed my life. Guys, it should never be that something has changed our life. It should be that it is changing our life. And if we are seeking the Lord, not just looking to him to teach us something and now we're good to go, thanks so much, God, we're good, we've got all this understanding, we get it, we can teach it, we can live it, we're good. When we get there, that's dangerous ground. Hear my heart when I say that's dangerous ground. It should be a continual learning, a continual growing, a reading the same thing over and over again and knowing that God can teach us something more. We never arrive at the status of we are professionals. We get it all. We understand it all. There's nothing we don't know about this topic or this topic. Guys, there is something we can always know that's more, that goes deeper. There's always more to learn, always more to grow in. That's the beauty of relationship with the Lord. It's this constant growth. And that is a sign of abundant life. Because if you are growing, then you are living. But if you are done growing, then you're on your way to death. You're on your way dying. You're either living or dying. And when we're growing, it's this life. And God says you don't have to grow to a flower and then shrivel away. You can keep growing. You can keep blooming and keep blossoming and keep discovering more about yourself, more about your Creator. That's what it is. And this right here, a wise man will hear an increase in learning. They'll increase. They'll want to learn more and more, understanding that there is more and more to know. That's the beginning signs of wisdom, of this understanding of who God is that there is no limit. That's the first step. There's no limit. And knowing that, then we can pursue more. We can pursue more of this unlimited grace and power and strength and love that God has for us. A wise man will hear and increase in learning. They can hear the same thing over and over again, but they continue to learn. It's this teachable spirit, hungry to learn and to grow and to be found in more, to be found deeper in Him, always more to know. Verse 7 says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Fools despise wisdom and instruction." The fear of the Lord. So this is understanding, like we said, that God, that there's no limit. He is unlimited in strength and power and goodness. There's an unlimited source of all of that goodness in God. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, is what it says. So fearing the Lord, we've got to know the Lord to fear Him. We've got to know who He is. We've got to know that there is no limit to His power. There is no limit to His love. We've got to know how holy He is, what He's capable of doing. When we know Him, then we can easily fear Him. We know His position, we know ours. We know what He's capable of. We know that we are capable of nothing without Him. The fear of the Lord, that we can fear Him, that we know, again, His position. We know His love. We know what He's capable of doing. We fear the Lord. And as we fear the Lord, as we show Him respect and reverence and we worship Him and we seek to know more of Him and we seek to grow closer to Him, closer to this power and strength, this grace, this goodness that He holds, that being the fear of the Lord, that's the beginning of knowledge. That's the beginning of our being awakened to everything and seeing things and understanding things and being able to live things out in this realness. That's knowledge. That's wisdom and being real with our life. And that comes from knowing the Lord, fearing the Lord, being under Him, being under His shadow, under His shade, under His protection, under His covering. There's knowledge there. God is everything we need. He is all awakening, all revelation, all wonder and awe. Fools despise wisdom and instruction. If they don't want to know what's right, if they're just busy, caught up, living according to their flesh, what they want, what they feel, they're not wanting to know what's right or wrong. They're not stopping to think, hey, how will this affect this person? How will this affect me? How will this affect my future? How will this affect my children? How will this affect my family? What is this going to look like in a year if I keep living like this? If we stop and think wisely like that, then that's wisdom. That's going to grow into all this beautiful growth, this beautiful life of peace. But if we don't, it says fools despise wisdom and instruction. They don't want to hear from other people. They want to do what they want, how they feel. They're going to do it without thinking about it. They're going to do it on a spur of a moment where it's like, ooh, I'm angry. I'm going to respond, or I'm going to react. More so, ooh, I feel this way and I'm just gonna go, I'm just gonna move. Fools despise wisdom, where they don't stop and think, they don't inquire of the Lord, they don't think about who God is, they don't think about how it's gonna affect them, they don't think about what's really in their heart, what they need, and how desperately they need God, how desperately they need Him to lead them. Fools despise. They despise wisdom and instruction. They don't need to know how to do things. They have this arrogance and this pride of saying, hey, I already know this. I already know this, so I don't need to listen. I already know this, so I don't need to respond. I'm just going to sit back here and do what I want while you just go whatever. They don't have this hunger to learn, this hunger to grow, this hunger for more. They're just content with where they're at, which gets them stagnant, which causes them to be foolish as they despise more wisdom and instruction to know so that they can continue obeying and following the Lord with such passion. Knowing the Lord and worshiping Him, it ushers us into knowledge and to wisdom. It causes us to long for His leading and for His revelation. That's wisdom. Fools despise that. They despise the instruction that God wants to give them. They say they don't need the word of God because they know what they should do. They know, you know, they go to church, they're fine. It's not this hunger for more that God wants. He says, you'll find wisdom there. You'll find wisdom in the depths of who I am. You come after me, you long for more. You long for the depths of who I am, and I will give you wisdom. You will see. You will know so clearly what the difference between good and evil is, right and wrong is. Light and darkness is, hope and hopelessness is, salvation and all of this being stuck in bondage and what this is, you'll know, you'll be awakened to it. Come after me, come deeper into me. Don't despise me, don't despise this, don't reject this relationship and all of this goodness that I'm offering you. Come into me and I will make you wise. I will be your wisdom. I will lead you into more. Verse 10 says, my son, if sinners entice you, do not consent. And the next few verses 11, through like 19, it talks about no matter what they say to you, if sinners entice you, if sinners come in and say, hey, let's do this, and we're going to make this amount of money, and we're going to do this, and this is going to make you popular, and this is going to get us here, this is going to get us ahead if you cheat the system here. Come and do this to these people. You know, it's not even going to mess with them. It's not going to phase them. Come do this. And this sounds great. And this will get you wealthy and popular and all of these things, stronger and better and more seen. What the word is saying in this Proverbs in chapter 1 and these few verses is saying, when they do that, when they come and entice you, no matter how good it sounds, no matter what, you be wise. You say no. You walk away. That's wisdom. And in knowing so clearly what God's word says compared to what these other people say, what the world is saying, what they're trying to get you to do. Hey, you'll find rest here. Hey, you'll be able to relax here. Hey, you'll clear your mind here. Hey, you'll feel better here. Hey, you'll have happiness, find happiness here. That wisdom is fearing the Lord. Wisdom is knowing God so that we can have that wisdom. We can be awakened to the difference between this. And right here, this proverb says, when they entice you, when sinners come in and tell you, hey, join us, hey, do this, this will bring you this, you say no. You absolutely refuse. You do not hang out with them because that's going to lead you into a life that's not going to give you any peace. That's not going to bring any rest. That's not going to bring any security, no stability. There's nothing there. So laying out this, when they do, no matter how good it sounds, say no. Verse 15, my son, do not walk in the way with them. They ambush their own lives. Then in verse 20, it talks about wisdom speaking out, shouting out. It says, wisdom shouts in the street. She lifts her voice in the square. At the head of the noisy street, she cries out. At the entrance of the gates in the city, she utters her sayings. How long, O naive ones, will you love being simple-minded? And scoffers delight themselves in scoffing, and fools hate knowledge. How long, O naive ones? What they're saying is, how long will you be content in not wanting more? How long will you be content in not wanting to know, not wanting to have this wisdom, not wanting to be awakened to what's right and wrong? We need to focus in, and we should be desiring to know, desiring for more and more so that we can continue walking on this path of peace instead of not knowing, holding on to just what we know and rolling with it and operating off of that, off of what we feel like we have gained and what we have discovered. When God says there's so much more, how long will you be content with what you have? Come after more. There's so much more. And unless you're growing, unless you're going after that more, you are going to find yourself in with the rest of the world. Away from me, away from this life of peace that I have for you that's constantly growing and changing and moving. And unless you're in it, unless you're going after it, you're going to miss it. You're going to be left behind. in the gunk of all that the world says is fun and is great and is the life that you want. How long will we be content and not wanting more? We've got to go after more. Verse 23, turn to my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit on you. I will make my words known to you. Let wisdom move. We've got to let wisdom out. We've got to let it take us deeper and continue to grow us and to develop in us. Then we see in verse 24, on down to 32, it's talking about if you don't want wisdom and instruction, if you're not wanting to be led, then you're not going to be led into blessing. If you're not wanting to know how to get to blessing, then you're not going to be led into blessing. It's that simple. It's saying, look, if you don't want it, you don't want it, but you're not going to have it. You're going to miss out on so much. You've got to make a decision. We have to make that decision. Do we want to learn? Do we want to understand God's truths? Not just the Bible studies, the simple ways that we heard it as a kid, but do we want to know them and learn them and be moved and changed by them for there to be genuine application that we can apply it to our everyday lives? That's wisdom. That's wisdom. God wants it so much further than knowledge. Get past knowledge. Get knowledge, understand what's going on, but let it lay a foundation for God to take you deeper, for there to be wisdom so that it can apply, that it can be lived out. If you don't want more of that, if you're not going after more, that depth, if you're not truly reading to learn and reading to for God to change things up in your life, if you're not reading that way, then you're going to miss out. You're not going to be led into the blessings that that wisdom holds, that that obedience holds. We've got to be going after God's call that he has for our life, what he wants from us, what he wants to show us, what he wants to reveal to us, and how he wants to use that in our lives to touch other people. And if we're not willing to receive that, to go after that, to pursue the Lord in that, then we're missing out on the blessings that God says, hey, this obedience, what I'm calling you into, this more, this depth here, it can give you so much more depth and blessing, so much more depth and peace and living abundantly in life. He's saying, if you want it, come after it. But if you're not after instruction, if you're not wanting to be reproved, if you're not excited about being convicted and things moving around in you, then you're not going to be able to experience the blessings I have. You're not going to be able to reach that depth. If you don't want the depth of understanding, you're not going to have the depth of these blessings. You're not going to have the depth of this fullness of life, the riches that I have for you in your life. Verse 33 says, but he who listens to me shall live securely and will be at ease from the dread of evil. Those who listen to him, if we are listening to God, if we are wanting him to take it deeper, if we're saying, okay, God, you show me what you want me to see. You open my eyes. Let me look into the situation and see what it is that you have for me, that you want to teach me. Teach me more. We're not going to sit around and let God, you know, expect him to pour out revelation on us. We're going to go after it. We're going to say, God, I may not understand this, but I'm going with it. I'm obeying and I am positioning myself for you to speak. Those who listen to him, those who are going after more, it says they shall live securely. They shall live. They shall have security. They shall have stability. They shall have peace in their life and know what blessing is. Let's jump into chapter 2. My son, if you will receive my words and treasure my commandments within you, make your ear attentive to wisdom, incline your heart to understanding. For if you cry for discernment, lift your voice for understanding. If you seek her as silver and search for her as the hidden treasures, then you will discern the fear of the Lord and discover the knowledge of God. For the Lord gives wisdom. From his mouth come knowledge and understanding. He stores up sound wisdom for the upright. He is a shield to those who walk in integrity, guarding the paths of justice, and he preserves the way of his godly ones. That's security. That is security to the max. That's stability. That's the peace that God promises us. For those who are going after more, who want to truly know, God, I want to know what you're calling me to do so that I can do it, so that I can be blessed, so that I can experience more of you. I can meet with you on a more intimate level in my relationship with you. It's going after. We have got to pursue him. We have got to read his word to know what it is we are, to know what it is, how we are to live, what we are to do. Unless we are going after it, we are not going to know what he says. We are not going to know what we are to do. We are not going to have the instructions and the leading into what this looks like and where we're to go with this, with having those instructions, with having his word, with listening to his voice. We are led into blessing, but we've got to go after it. We've got to want to see it. We have got to want to hear his voice and pursue him. And he will not run from us. He will not hide from us. If we're going after him, he will. And we see the faithfulness in this, that he is a shield to those who walk in integrity, guarding the paths of justice. He preserves the way of his godly ones. From his mouth come knowledge and understanding. If we want understanding, if we want wisdom, if we want to know what's going on, then let's read. It comes from his mouth, what he has spoken to us, how he speaks into our heart. Are we listening to know? Are we pursuing him and wanting, desiring, longing, aching to hear him speak? Are we aching to hear his voice so that we can obey, believing him, trusting him, standing assured in his faithfulness? If we receive his words, treasure his commands, if we are pursuing him, going after him, seeking him out like the greatest treasure in the world, if we are trusting him, pursuing him in that way and saying, Lord, I value, I treasure your words. I treasure your commands. I want them sunken into my heart so I am moved according to your commands, moved according to your words, believing that this is the life I want. This life is full. This life will lead me into peace and more of your presence. Verse 10 says, for wisdom will enter your heart and knowledge will be pleasant to your soul. Discretion will guard you. Understanding will watch over you to deliver you from the way of evil. We will be protected and guarded and secure from the men and women who live in foolishness and wickedness. And this lays it out in the end of chapter 2. Those who delight in doing evil, who rejoice in the perversity of evil, whose paths are crooked, who are devious in their ways. Verse 16 says, to deliver you, this wisdom, this going after God, this listening to his voice, this treasuring his commandments in our heart, and stopping and reflecting and remembering what the Lord says, standing on who he says he is and who we are, in those things, wanting more, wanting to know what to do, inquiring of the Lord in every decision we make. And those things, it gives the power to do this in verse 16, to deliver you from the strange woman, from the adulteress who flatters with her words. Guys, this is power to the man who struggles with lust, to the man who struggles with sexual sins. Do we hear this? To deliver you from the strange woman, from the adulteress who flatters with her words, that leaves the companion of her youth and forgets the covenant of her God. For her house sinks down to death, and her tracks lead to the dead. Wisdom is seeing that. Wisdom is seeing this woman who's running from the Lord. And it says that her tracks lead to the dead. Her house sinks down to death. Where she dwells, how she remains in her seducing and her presenting herself, exposing herself, you know, expressing herself in a way that tries to draw you in, where she dwells, her house, it sinks, and her path, her tracks lead to death. It's wisdom. It's wisdom in seeing that and pointing it out and saying the Lord gives us the path that we should take. The Lord speaks wisdom. He is our wisdom. When we pursue him, we are not following that path down to death. We are not sinking along with the enemy, that the promises, the deceit that he gives us and saying, no, this is for real. This will give you pleasure. Wisdom. Wisdom is fearing the Lord. Wisdom is seeing the Lord, is pursuing the Lord, is standing on his word and saying, wisdom will bring peace. Wisdom will bring a full life. That will bring satisfaction. That will bring joy and salvation and healing into me. Verse 20, so you will walk in the way of good men and keep to the paths of righteous, for the upright will live in the land, and the blameless will remain in it, but the wicked will be cut off from the land, and the treacherous will be uprooted from it. Clear as day, wisdom. That's what wisdom does. It keeps us off those paths. It keeps us from following the world's way of thinking and living and loving and being. The world is going to suck us in and trample on us when God is saying, my path will lead to victory, to freedom, to success, to prosperity, to peace, to all of this goodness. And all we have to do is run after the Lord, is choose wisdom, is choose to trust the words of the Lord and saying, God, you spoke this to me. You said that you're not withholding any good thing from me. You promised to never leave me. You promised that you see, that you love, that you reward those who live in righteousness, that you will uphold those who walk uprightly, those who are pursuing you, that you will give long life, that you will prosper them, that you will sustain life. God is saying, I will do all this for you. The world says, hey, you could have all this, and ends up trampling on you, suffocates you, keeping you down, and you are left without peace and restlessness, hopelessness and dark confusion, wondering what to do next, striving and needing more. When God says, you come into me and you'll receive everything, and guess what? There's so much more than everything. There's more depth and more layers to everything. There's more. There's no limit in me. If you want peace, come after me. It's found in me along this path. I can be your wisdom. Read and heed to my voice. Listen to my commandments. Listen to what I'm telling you to do. When I call you to do something, it's for you. And in your obedience, you will live in that life of peace, in that life of rest. This is life abundant, and it's for you. Pouring out, my spirit is pouring out upon you this power and this peace that wisdom will lead you into. Will lead you into this blessing. That's wisdom. And finding wisdom, the pursuit of wisdom, and pursuing the Lord as our wisdom. We need him. We need to be found in him, and he will lead us, and he will speak, and he will help, and he will guide. He will bring us there. He will carry us into more and more. He will take us down deeper and deeper and deeper, where the richness of blessings are, those unique, those rare treasures that only those who are digging, only those who are seeking will find them. That's a guarantee. That's faithfulness. That's God's provision. That's the blessing of wisdom. And that's what God says you come after. Here it is, laid out for you. I offer it to you. I am your wisdom. Come after me. That is a legit life. That is a straight up full life in the Lord. So good. Love Proverbs. Love the simplicity of it. Love how God just wants to take it deeper. Love everything about it. So let's keep going after the Lord. Let's keep discovering his heart. This is all for this video. Our next video, we're going to hit just one chapter. So stick with me. Let's keep journeying this thing together. Yes. Yes. And amen. So good. Thanks so much. See you soon.